Isang paalaala, ang susunod na kabanata ay naglalaman ng mga salita at pahayag na maaaring magdulot ng takot, pangamba at pagkabahala sa mga nakikinig, lalo na sa mas nakababatang gulang. Huwag magpatuloy kung kinakailangan. Magandang gabi po sa inyong lahat. Ako si Earl at ako po ang inyong Campmaster. At ito ang Philippine Camper Stories. Welcome to episode 232. And we are still on a San Telmo Society break. But tonight, I'll be reading a different story. It's about a peculiar restaurant nestled and hidden in the walled city of Intramuros. What if in one of your walks, you'll find a magical place that lets you travel in time, as long as you have a cup of halo-halo. Are you in a mood for dessert? Let's go to Cafe Gerardo's and tread in time. Pero bago yan, here are a few reminders from our sponsors.
Mga Immortal, listen to the Underpaid Podcast with me, Stanley Chi, wherein we talk about work-related topics in a light manner na parang nagchichismisan lang tayo or nagkukwentuhan. Listen for free on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, or kung saan ka man nakikinig ng podcast. Kita kits!
And now, our story for the day. Hidden within the historic walls of Intramuros, where cobblestone streets echo with the whispers of centuries past, lies a garden oasis bursting with tropical blooms and shaded by ancient acacia trees. At the heart of this lush garden stands Gerardo's, a charming cafe renowned not just for its delectable halo-halo, but also for its extraordinary ability to transcend time. Gerardo's is an architectural marvel designed in the Antillean style that echoes the Spanish colonial past in the Philippines. The restaurante features wide, inviting verandas, capiz shell windows, and intricate wood carvings on its balustrades. The roof is clad in red clay tiles, and the walls are painted a warm, creamy hue that glows softly in the sunlight. Upon entering, Gerardo's visitors are greeted by a cozy, nostalgic ambiance. The interior is adorned with a vintage wooden furniture, delicate lace curtains, and walls decorated with sepia-toned photographs of old Manila. Ceiling fans lazily spin overhead, casting a gentle breeze that carries the sweet scent of flowers and freshly brewed coffee. The wooden floors creak softly underfoot, adding to the old-world charm. Gerardo's is no ordinary cafe. Its halo-halo is not just a dessert,
but a portal to the past.
Those in the know, especially the seers from Quiapo Church, talk impressively of this time-bending cafe. One of these ladies of vision once saw that a certain national figure of the late 1800s was a frequent visitor of Gerardo's, who was using the time-traveling restaurant to learn about the country's captors and how we can emerge free from their iron fist. However, the frequency of his visits became too often that he forgot to follow the rules of the restaurant and found himself in a fatal end.
Mapanatag ka, anak ko. Hindi mapupunta sa wala ang iyong mga pagtitiis at pagmamalasakit sa bayang ito.
Apunte! Gregor!
Now, if you promise not to share with anyone, here are the magical rules that govern time travel at Gerardo's, so you yourself can go and experience this phenomenon. single serving rule. Only one halo-halo per person per visit can trigger time travel. Regardless of how many servings you order, you only get one ticket per day. There was once a wealthy hacendera from Ilocos who came to the restaurant at one time and stayed and refused to go after one serving. She bribed the waiter with jewels and money, thinking she could go forth her way. The cunning waiter took the hacendera's prized jewels. However, the moment she got the halo-halo and consumed it in reverence, she found herself in the same exact spot. She was laughing hysterically at the silliness of it, on how close she was going back to her youth. But alas, the power of time shouldn't be trifled with. Pure intentions. The cafe's wise and enigmatic owner must approve each traveler's journey. She has an uncanny ability to sense the purity of their intentions. Let's just say that some of the ill-intentioned visitors that tried her met some of her quote-unquote friends. There was a time when a traveler sat on a course to the 1966 Beatles concert in Manila. Javier, the traveler, was able to go back only to steal the songs that one of the band members was making. Esperanza's friends, the guardians of the time-traveling magic at Gerardo's, went back to follow the pursuit of Javier. The supernatural effect made by the guardians caused a paradigm shift that year that resulted with the Beatles being assaulted and their entourage robbed and humiliated during that year. One destination per visit. Each journey must focus on a specific time and place. Attempting to visit multiple periods in one trip can disrupt the magic. A local albularyo from Pampanga tried to override the magic of time traveling by using a tagabulag, an akimat that cloaks the wearer. He thought by wearing a tagabulag that he can go to multiple periods and collect treasures hidden in time. Safe to say, he remained hidden in time and forever lost and unseen. You can go back to the last rule and this makes more sense. No future travel. The cafe's magic is strictly confined to the journeys in the past, with the future remaining a veiled mystery, even to the proprietor, Esperanza. This restriction is a testament to the profound respect Gerardo's has for the sanctity of time and the natural progression of events. Esperanza, for all her extraordinary powers, has chosen to exercise great caution and restraint when it comes to peering into the unknown realm of the future. Even the slightest intervention in the course of events could have cataclysmic consequences, unraveling the delicate tapestry of time and altering the destinies of untold lives. Moreover, the future remains a mystery to all, even the most powerful of seers and mystics. To attempt to breach that barrier would be to court disaster, potentially unleashing forces beyond your control. There may be other avenues for those seeking a glimpse into the future. The alleys of Quiapo, a bustling district in Manila, are home to the legendary seer Lola Fortunata, who is rumored to possess the ability to divine the shape of things to come. Guardian spirits. Each traveler is assigned a spectral guide, a guardian spirit whose sole purpose is to ensure the safety and integrity of the traveler's journey through the annals of time. This guardian spirit is not merely a passive observer, but an active participant in the time-traveling process, a benevolent and watchful presence that accompanies the patron on their chosen journey. Its role is multifaceted, ranging from the mundane tasks of guiding the traveler through the labyrinthine pathways of the past to the more complex and vital duty of preventing any significant alterations of timeline. Esperanza, the cafe's enigmatic owner, understands the immense power and responsibility that comes with wielding the ability to manipulate the flow of time. She has, therefore, implemented this safeguard to ensure that her patrons do not inadvertently create ripples that could have devastating consequences on the fabric of reality. These guardian spirits are not mere figments of imaginations, but rather manifestations of Gerardo's own ancient, otherworldly, quote-unquote, friends. They are entities whose true nature and origins remains shrouded in mystery. Interestingly, as you've noted, the guardian spirit that is assigned to each visitor is uniquely attuned to that individual. Only the traveler themselves can discern the presence and nature of their spectral guide. For the bond between the patron and the guardian is a deeply personal and intuitive one. The guardian spirit may manifest in various forms, perhaps as a majestic winged creature, or as wise and benevolent ancestor, depending on the individual traveler's own unique experiences and beliefs. Regardless of its form, the guardian spirit's presence is a reassuring one, a constant reminder that the traveler is not alone on their journey, and that their actions are being monitored and guided by forces far greater than themselves. Memory Lock. The magical restaurant grants its patrons the remarkable ability to retain all of their memories from their journeys through the past. This is a gift, to be sure, for it allows the traveler to fully savor and integrate the profound insights and experiences they have gleaned from their forays into the bygone eras. However, this gift comes with a catch, a safeguard, if you will, that is designed to prevent a cafe secret from being revealed to the uninitiated. The moment a traveler attempts to share the wonders of Gerardo's with someone who has not experienced it firsthand, they risk a most curious and unsettling consequences: the placement of a barang upon one of their memories. This barang, a term that speaks to the arcane and mystical forces at play, is a form of protective enchantment that effectively severs the traveler's connection to a specific memory. And the truly unnerving aspect of this rule is that the traveler has no say in which memory will be affected. It is entirely up to the whims of Gerardo's own unseen guardians. The restaurant's time-traveling magic is not to be taken lightly, nor is it to be shared indiscriminately, for they hold the potential to shape the very course of history itself. And last, the most important rule, the melting countdown. The final and perhaps the most crucial rule governing the time-traveling experience at the Gerardos: the imperative to return before the last shave ice melts. This is a rule that speaks to the delicate and precarious nature of the restaurant's temporal magic, and the dire consequences that await to those who fail to heed its warning. The shave ice, you see, is not merely a refreshing treat for the weary time traveler, but rather a physical manifestation of the temporal portal that allows them to traverse the boundaries of past and present. As the ice slowly melts away, it serves as a tangible countdown, a ticking clock that reminds the patron of the urgency to complete their journey and return to the present before the connection is severed. It is the final line of defense against the chaos and catastrophe that could ensue should a traveler become stranded in the past. And so the patrons of Gerardo's must remain ever vigilant, their senses attuned to the slow, steady progression of melting ice. They must be prepared to drop everything and hurry back to the present the moment they sense the last crystals begin to disappear. For the alternative is simply too dire to contemplate. It is a rule that speaks to the incredible power and responsibility that comes with Gerardo's gift of time travel. Those are the rules of time travel at Gerardo's. Now, are you ready for a halo halo? That was a short story called Cafe Gerardo's, a restaurant that lets you go back in time. Now, is it inspired by a certain book based in Tokyo that lets you time travel in a coffee shop? I won't say, due to copyrights. Let's just say that the cafe in Tokyo and the restaurant in Intramuros are in the same line of time travel network, at least in my mind. I have always wondered about Intramuros and have always admired the beauty of it. Kaya, syempre, ginawad ko ng sarili kong kwento. Like, why is it walled? Who are they trying to keep out? Or better yet, are the walls installed to keep something in? Why is it always the place for mysteries? And I know that there are historical reasons why those are there, but you know. Kaya ayan, gumawa ako ng sariling kwento tungkol sa Intramuros. I hope you like the story I wrote. Find more of these short fictional stories over at patreon.com/campfirestoriesph. Dito na po nagtatapos ang ating kwento. For our campers na feeling mo ay good job ang podcast sa pagsama sa iyo sa mga araw-araw na gawain at naiimsan ang pagkainip mo at medyo feeling generous ka today, you can send love and appreciation. Daanan mo lang yung PayPal account natin for your tips. Search earlm.work@gmail.com over at PayPal. You can also check out the episode show notes for the link. Or better yet, go to our Patreon page. Magpunta ka lang sa patreon.com/campfirestoriesph at mag-subscribe ka na. You'll get to have access sa ating mga full video podcast agad-agad. For as little as $1 to $5, you can check out all those videos that we have in Patreon. Kaya try mo na! Kung gusto mo namang makapanood ng libre lang, ay magpunta ka sa YouTube at hanapin ang Philippine Camper Stories. At nandoon ang mga previews ng mga video episodes natin. Mag-subscribe ka na din kasi libre lang yun. You can also stay for the ads at the end of the show kasi those ads keep our show running here for free. Anyway, panghuli, kung may kwento ka naman na gusto mong ibahagi sa ating camp, ay pwede mong isend yan sa campfirestoriesph@gmail.com at babasahin natin yan sa mga susunod na San Telmo Society episodes. Muli, maraming salamat po sa inyong pakikinig. Magkita tayong muli sa susunod na kwento. Ako si Earl at ito ang Philippine Camper Stories.
This podcast may be based on true events with names, characters, and incidents that are either products of the creator's imagination or used fictitiously. Any similarity to real individuals or events is coincidental.